This is a quick preview of my nap and value angle selections, but for all our ITV races selections, please click on the link below. Hi betting experts, on Saturday, December the 11th, we've got seven brilliant races on ITV on Saturday, three at Doncaster, four at Cheltenham, the highlight at Cheltenham, the International Hurdle at 3 o'clock. We've also got the Caspian Caviar Gold Cup at 1:50 over at Donny. The Summit Juvenile at 2:40 is a cracking race where Paul Nicholls' Morimal is likely to be very hard to beat. Let's take a look at the races one by one, starting off at Cheltenham, where the grounds on the softer side are good. There are showers forecast, but it should be pretty much perfect with no excuses. We start off in the 1:50, which is the Caspian Caviar Gold Cup, 2 mile 4, 8-1 the field for looking this morning, and the one I much prefer is Nigel Twiston Davis's Al Dance, and that is our betting expert value angle selection on the day. Now, this progressive chaser had his form franked. He beat Master Tommy Tucker at Newton Abbott first time out this season. That runner-up has since come out and won twice since to frank it, and Al Dancer has gone on to run really well himself. He ran a screamer into handicaps over this course and distance last time out when third behind Cool Cody. A couple of errors at the wrong time making the difference on ground that was plenty soft enough for him. These drying conditions should suit. He's open to more improvement, and I think the key to this race is there's loads of pace on. Four or five of them want to go off in front. I think Sam Twiston Davis will bide his time in rear and come through strongly up the hill. The 3 o'clock, the day's highlight, the Unibet International Hurdle, 2 miles, and I really like Chitty Bello here of Dan Skelton's. I think overpriced and is a sporting nap on a competitive day. Now, this warrior is a real model of consistency with a terrific record at Cheltenham. 3 wins from 24, placed on 13 other occasions, often in big weights in top handicaps. He won the county hurdle here in 2019. He was third in this race last year. He ran really well on his return off a wind operation behind Summerhill Boy at Aintree last month, travelling smoothly, perhaps ridden with a shade over confidence out wide and never quite getting there against the very resolute winner. But he's got a good make-up here. I don't fancy Goshen at all. I don't think they've got the horse right at home. He's been really disappointing on the flat twice this season. They haven't been happy with him. He's been a non-runner twice in big races at the weekend, and he's got plenty to prove for me. Generally speaking, juveniles do really struggle in their second season over hurdles. And the 3:15, a competitive staying handicap chase, I think I've narrowed it down to two. Single Farm Payment, who I think will go well, but he doesn't win too many. And Boldmere of Caroline Bailey, who has run really well at Doncaster in the past. The course and distance winner on good ground last season. And this one shaped particularly well last time, looking like coming back to full fitness under a negative ride, I thought, at Bangor, making a couple of mistakes in rear when trying to close. Should now be spot on and has ideal conditions to try and win at Doncaster again. Best of luck on Saturday, betting experts.